Oh boy, look at this. We've done it now, everybody. Getting into something different and something a lot of you are probably going to be really excited to see run. We're going to try our hands at our first SUV derby. Don't know how well this is going to go. It's going to be a quick build, of course, like everything this year. We don't even know if this vehicle even runs and moves correctly. We're going kind of in blind on this, but we're going to give it a shot and see what happens. Let's give you a quick backstory on this vehicle. We've had this for several months. This is a 96, 97. Let's see if it's on the door. Yep, 96. So we got ourselves a 1996 Ford Explorer Eddie Bauer Edition, the King Tut of the road back in the day. Everybody had Explorers, Exploders as they called them. Heck, even my parents back in the day had one of these Eddie Bauer things, was pulling their camper and traveling all across the states with it. So, very common ride to get around in. I do like the older one, being a 96 here. It does have better suspension. Overall, I think just a tougher vehicle before you get in some of the newer ones. But, so what do we know about it? So we got this for several months ago, and the game plan was actually to run it in a different derby way back in, I don't know, June or July. But that event got canceled. We bought it specifically for that event. That event never happened, and we just had this thing sitting since then. We're like, okay, we'll find a use for it. Well, we have a show coming up now, which is going to be a fall Halloween derby. And it's going to have a super stock SUV minivan class there at this event. And Susan's going to run this thing in SUVs and give it a shot. She ran full size with the Crown Vic for her first time, her only time doing full size. Didn't go so well, had zero traction in that Vic because it was street tires, what we thought were those rules for that event that we went to. Didn't end up being the same of what we brought for tires. That will not be the case this time. You know why? Because this Explorer already solved our tire problem when we bought it. Check this bad boy out. It came with some pretty darn Goodyear mud tires already on the whole back of this in really good shape. Heck, still has some of the hairs and the nubs on the side of this tire. Very expensive mud tires. Probably could have sold these for an okay amount and helped pay off some of this vehicle, but I don't have anything else to use as mud tires, so we're probably stuck using them unless I come across something else before then. Really good deal to have those on the back of this already. And then as far as the front goes, not too worried. Street tires, whatever. It's steering tires. Is what it is. So what's the deal with this car? We bought it, and all we know about it is the owner said the fuel pump was out. That much I have confirmed, because the simplest trick for a fuel pump test, if you guys are ever buying a vehicle and you're like, oh man, are these people lying to me? Is the fuel pump actually out? Well, all you gotta do is jump it and spray starting fluid down the throttle into the motor while cranking over, and if it fires off and then stalls back out in a couple seconds, that probably means the fuel pump's bad, because your spark system, your ignition is all working. The spray can was enough to ignite it, run it for a couple seconds until the spray ran out of the engine. And that's what this thing did. It fired up. There was no ticking, no knocking. It actually ran on all cylinders really smooth for the brief time frame. Of course, you can keep the motor running if you keep firing that spray can in there, which we did for a bit. And it sounded pretty darn healthy for what we had going with the spray can. And that was good enough for me. We got it, and we got it home. Now, we've never had this thing actually running and moving since then, because I have not put a pump in it or done anything to this vehicle. Once that event got canceled, we jumped ship and we were working on other derby vehicles. So, here we are now, dragging this thing out of the field. We got it up here. My first goal is to go ahead and splice in just a quick basic fuel pump setup to this vehicle so we can get it running, see if there's any other major issues we know about that could potentially stop this from getting built for our derby this quick. We got a month to build this, but within that month we have two weddings to go to, so you might as well just throw those weekends out the window because we're going to be gone out of state. So we basically have two full weekends and then whatever couple hours we get every day after work during the week to get this thing built. It's going to be thrown together by all means. But luckily, it is a very stock class. There's no chromes on the vehicles that are running this class. There's no aftermarket skid loader tires, crazy stuff like that. No creasing, no anything at all. Very minimalistic cage, wiring, no heavy welds. Yeah, I believe even the bumpers are bolt-on bumpers only. Have to be newer style bumpers, like your 92 and newer bumpers. So if we run out of time, we run what's on it. It's got chromes front and back. It's okay of a bumper, good enough for a bone stock class. If not, I have a couple ideas. We're going to try to bolt something on the front of this and we'll see what happens. But we still don't know if the transmission's good. We don't know if there's any unknown major mechanical failures with the motor. Head gasket could be blown and it floods itself out as soon as it starts running. I don't know. I'm going to just hypothetically assume it's good minus the fuel pump because where's my spot? There it is. So my gauges there are only showing 176,000 miles on this, which, to be honest, for a Ford Explorer from the 90s, I believe that's pretty decent miles. That's not anywhere in the danger zone of the powertrain being completely junk in this Ford Explorer. I would assume it's still good enough to go. I've seen a lot of these Ford Explorers with very high miles out there taking some crazy abuse on the roads and still be good to go. So that's my only reasoning in my mind that I'm hoping everything comes out okay with this. Another really cool thing about this vehicle, besides the fact that it is super clean, as you can see here, no rust, all over the body is clean. I bet you there's some hiding behind this plastic fender trim. That's a given, rocker, step pad, that's normal. But the actual frame on this, pretty darn good. I'm happy with it. I'll get up on here and show you. Look at that. You got your typical brown surface rust, but it's solid through and through all the way to the back bumper. Motor mounts, the rubber's not rotted out, nothing's stripped out there, core support's clean, and somebody put some serious money and time into trying to keep this thing on the road because we have brand new lower control arms. We got stabilizer bars right there, sway bar ends, been brand new and redone. We got brand new upper ball joints put in this thing. I think it's probably new lower ball joints. We got brand new tie rods on the steering. I mean, somebody went through and dumped some money and time into redoing all the suspension on this thing. So, all kinds of new parts there. That should not be an issue for us in the Derby, blowing a ball joint out. It's going to take some serious abuse to get to that point. But other than that, it's your typical crappy abandoned SUV. I believe this was sitting in the ghetto for quite some time when the fuel pump went out. Whoever had it just bought a different vehicle and ignored this one instead of putting a pump in it. Maybe they spent all their money on the suspension and then they gave up. I don't know. But it's filled full of trash. We haven't even gotten through this vehicle. It is full of tires. Seems to be a common thing when you buy vans and SUVs. People just love to hide garbage in them and not have to worry about it. These are probably the old ones before they put the mud tires on the back of it. My guess is they were having issues maybe in the snow during the winter. So they put those on it and they were using it on the road. I don't know. The back of it surprisingly still works. The hydraulic arms here still hold this thing in the air. The hatch is good, so that's cool. There's our rear bumper. It does have a hitch on it. Not allowed to run the hitch, so we got to cut that part off of it to run that. But back in here, we're going to see what kind of floor pan we got in this, if it's rotted out at all. I don't know if it had water leaks or if they ever left it open. We'll find out once we get all of this random junk and trash cleaned out of the back of this. So, throw that in there. Other than that, I'll show you underneath the back. It's pretty clean too. Pretty happy there. Rear end. Now, this thing does have your C-channel rear frame. Not a fully boxed rear frame. This, that is something to remember on these. So we'll see how that factors in. Again, not much we can do about that regardless. We're not notching, we're not plating, tubing, nothing we can do per rules for this to stop that. Just use what we got. Engine-wise, this is a V6, not a V8, which I'm personally happy about because with a bone stock class, you know there's going to be radiators popping left and right. Having a V6 is probably going to run a little bit longer when it gets hot out there. And I'm still not 100% sure, but I'm entertaining the idea of looping this, if I can do it right. It's going to be a very fast-paced event. It's going to fold the fronts of all these vehicles very easy. The radiator is probably going to blow out in this thing pretty darn fast with a soft chrome bumper like this or something else on it. And I'd rather have hot water in a loop kit than have no water at the bottom of a radiator within the first minute. So just my thoughts. I don't know. I know very little about SUVs, so I'm kind of excited to experiment and get something new out here to work on. If we like this, we can come across some more out here in the country when we move to. I think we'll have a little bit easier access to find these type of vehicles before, closer to the city. Not so much of a thing to get them cheap. So we'll see. We'll dig into all of this and keep you guys updated. That is just the first announcement to let you guys know what we have and what we're going to dig into. Stay tuned. When I get this thing running and hopefully moving, we'll get it on camera as we test out any other failures. Oh, and it doesn't have brakes. I mean, are we really surprised about that? It's a 90s Ford. When has a 90s Ford ever had brakes that I brought home? It's pretty darn surprising. So, let's dig into this. Stay tuned for the next video.